have a question. When are we going to get Courtney Stodden's take on Israel and Palestine? That's whose opinion I really want. It's rare when it happens, but it does happen. There is major drama going on within the conservative movement, and I've got all the conservatea on the big fight between Candace Owens and Nicol Earbour. There's a rapper getting a home improvement show on HGTV. Instagrammers are lying to you about their bodies and pop culture rewind. I'm AlexClark, and this is POPlitics. Nobody is there drama in the conservative movement. And as your resident certified gossip specialist, I am here to deliver it in a pretty pink package. Seeing our own people get into it kind of reminds me of this scene from When a Stranger Calls.
Leave me alone!
Jill, this is Sergeant Sacker. Listen to me. We've traced the call. It's coming from inside the house. Our squad car's on the way over there right now. Just get out of that house.
You should know by now that Candace Owens has a brand new talk show with the Daily Wire called Candace. She has celebrity guests and panels and all the things. You can actually watch the show on the Daily Wire app or their website and get a discount with code Chrissy. Which brings me into what the fight was all about. On this week's panel, Candace had Brandon Tatum, TurningPointUSA contributor Aaron Elmore, and YouTuber and comedian Nicol Earbour.
If you're looking for a sign that today's gonna be the best day ever, this is your sign.
When the story broke about Chrissy Teigen being a larger-than-life bully on social media back in the day, Candace started the hashtag #CancelChrissyTeigen, encouraging people to put pressure on places that she has brand deals with to drop her after this news came out. Now, Nicol did an Instagram Live explaining that she vehemently opposed this and said, if you support it as a conservative, you're a P-word, and she wants to debate it with you.
And to people who may be on the right in America, who are like, cancel culture in the same breath as tweeting #CancelChrissyTeigen, the f are you doing?
Clearly, even though she didn't name names, she was calling out Candace Owens. So Candace had her producers track down Nicol and invite her to Nashville to go on her show and debate whether or not Chrissy Teigen should be canceled for encouraging a teenage girl to commit suicide repeatedly. During the taping, Nicol gets pissed off because Candace was just owning her, and she gets mad because, you know, they're quoting the actual quotes that she said in her own Instagram Live. Here's the best clip of Candace explaining the whole situation.
The entire reason we offered to have her on the show was because she requested the debate. And it just ended up being a situation where she first and foremost told us that we were not allowed to air the footage. We obviously pulled out a minute and a half of what, you know, of what she posts on Instagram to give the audience context in case they hadn't seen the Instagram Live that she did. She did not, she said that that footage doesn't make me look good. It was literally her Instagram Live. It's not like it was deceptively edited. She said that portion makes it look like I'm supporting Chrissy Teigen. I mean, no one, like, I mean, she actually blatantly supports Chrissy Teigen on the panel. You mess with the bull, you get the horns.
Now, joining me today to give some more context to the situation and behind the scenes conservatee is TPUSA contributor and my friend, Aaron Elmore, who can tell us more about exactly what happened since she was actually there on the panel.
And I tell you what, it got hot and spicy. The two ladies were feuding over the topic of Chrissy Teigen. Candace believes that she should have been canceled because she was advocating for horrible things against young girls and really bullying them, even saying things like kill yourself. And Nicol tried to chalk it up to cancel culture and said conservatives shouldn't do that. Well, this fight went back and forth and back and forth, and I felt like I was in the middle of a really scary, crazy ping pong match. And I tell you what, Nicol really didn't come with proper arguments. And the worst thing that she did is in these videos she made before the show, she called Candace a P word and a B word. Spoiler alert, that's a bad idea for a lady to talk like that. It's a bad idea for a lady to talk like that to Candace Owens. So I think you know exactly what happened if you haven't seen already. But a little behind the scenes scoop. Before we went on air, no one knew this was gonna happen. They were very cool. Everyone was calm, cool, and collected. And once we got on the set, it was all systems go, flying. So it was a really crazy interaction. I was sitting in the middle of them, sweating, palpating, so uncomfortable. I didn't know what to do. And in that environment, Candace just gets stronger and sharper and even better. So I tell you what, I think these two girls, they're gonna have beef for some time now. I don't think that they're gonna be friends. Even Nicole said that. She said, I thought we were friends. And Candace says, I don't know. I don't have friends that call me the P word or the B word. With friends like that, who needs liberal enemies?
Now you gotta watch Candace's show to actually see what all she had to say about canceling Chrissy Teigen and if it's warranted. I think the point that Candace was trying to make is that there's a difference between saying that we need to cancel somebody, take away their livelihood and stuff because of a political view you don't like, and then canceling someone or holding them accountable for behavior that is criminal and also against a child.
A child deserves better.
I have to say, I think where Candace went wrong, possibly, if we're going to consider what Nicole was maybe trying to say at all, is using the word cancel. I think that's what's getting, you know, people like Nicole up in arms, is that you're saying you're against cancel culture, yet you're saying cancel Chrissy Teigen. Maybe it should have been cancel cravings, which is Chrissy Teigen's brand. I don't know. But maybe the word cancel is where we're on the hang up here. Either way, I don't think Chrissy's behavior is defensible in any way, shape, or form. So where do you stand? Are you Team Nicole or Team Candace? Remember Lil Jon? Big, just one of the biggest rappers of the early 2000s. Well, you know you're getting old when he gets an HGTV show.
What?
It looks like HGTV and Lil Jon are teaming up to do a home renovation show this summer called Lil Jon Wants to Do What? Where the rapper offers skeptical homeowners startlingly. Guys, here's the deal. The word is
startlingly.
I can't say the word. This is a direct quote. We're keeping that, keeping it in. Okay, so they're offering
startlingly
unconventional renovation ideas that seem impossible to execute according to a release. Now that's how you read a quote. So the show is starting to shoot now in Atlanta. So Atlanta CUTEservatives, you'll have to let us know any peach juicy juice in the comments, okay?
Okay!
Before I get to the pop culture rewind next, I just want to show you something really quick. This reel that somebody sent me completely changed my life yesterday when I saw it. I don't know about you, but if you find yourself comparing your body a lot to girls on Instagram, stop. It's legit all fake, and I needed to see this, so maybe you do too.
Let's go. Left foot, right foot, levitate. Pop stars, do a leap with the baby. I had to lace my shoes for all the blessings I was chasing. If I ever slip, I fall into a better situation. So catch up, go put some cheese on it, get out and get your bread up. They always leave when you fall, but you run together. Weight of the world on my shoulders.
I probably watched that 200 times. Remember that next time you look in the mirror and you're hard on yourself.
This is San Francisco. Do you know what this building is worth? The foundation, the masonry, you might as well have thrown a grenade through the window. The only option now is controlled demolition.
All right, here's what happened this week in pop culture history with the Pop Culture Rewind. In 1962 this week, Marilyn Monroe sang her famous Happy Birthday, Mr. President, to President John F. Kennedy at NYC's Madison Square Garden.
Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday, Mr. President. Happy birthday to you.
This week in 2001, Shrek, our daddy, was released in movie theaters.
I'm all alone. There's no one here beside me.
2005 this week, the tallest roller coaster in the world, Kingda Ka, opened at Six Flags Great Adventure in Jackson Township, New Jersey.
Holy crap. Now that's what I'm talking about.
Now in 2021, the tallest roller coaster is currently being built. It's going to be called Falcon's Flight at Six Flags in Saudi Arabia. Now, the good news news is for women in Saudi Arabia, they ride this roller coaster, they have the full burqa on, they don't get their hair messed up. But the bad news is afterwards, nobody can see it.
Abort.
In 2005, this week, Tom Cruise famously jumped around on Oprah Winfrey's couch, proclaiming his love for Katie Holmes.
I love cinnamon rolls! I got pants on.
We've never seen you behave this way before.
I know.
Have you ever felt this way before?
And finally, this week, in 2009, Glee premiered on Fox.
People always tell you to follow your dreams.
I'd like to take over Glee Club.
You want to captain the Titanic too?
What they don't tell you...
My gold stars are a metaphor for me being a star.
...is how much it can hurt.
And that's what you missed on Glee. Just kidding. That's what happened this week in pop culture history. Ending on a CUTEservative submission, y'all. Someone out there is doing little worm tattoos. Should I get one of these?
Anybody there? Hello?
I'm not actually getting one, but if I did, which one should it be? I hope you've confirmed your spot to YWLS by now. You do not have hardly any time left, so get on that. Don't forget to like this episode. There is so much to discuss in the comments today with the Candace Nicol fight. Share this episode to your stories. Encourage your followers to join the CUTEservative fam and follow us. Do me a favor, please hit that save button too. Tomorrow at 4 p.m. Eastern, 1 p.m. Pacific, by request, I present to you, drum roll, my headband, Demi Lovato, coming out as non-binary as this week's Freak of the Week. It's pop culture without the propaganda every single day. I'm Alex Clark, and this is POPlitics. Ooh, it's spicy today! Click below to watch yesterday's episode. Please subscribe, thumbs up, share this video, and ring the bell for notifications so you never miss the CONSERVATEA. And make sure you're following this show at POPlitics on Instagram for even more CUTEservative content.